Italy is a country with a great history. Italy is 0.5% of the Earth's surface and has 0.8% of the Earth's inhabitants. However, Italy holds 70% of the world's artistic heritage. It is a country where the new and modern coexist with the old, even ancient. This mix is inspirational, and it has driven the development of Trafimet for over 40 years. At Trafimet, we believe that products that we produce must always be well-performing and long-lasting, but also distinctive by design. This year, Trafimet presents an updated brand. We wanted our new brand image to represent all potential of the future, as well as our genuine, strong roots. From the past through the present to the future, Trafimet has represented a well-known brand, appreciated by leading industrial companies in the field of welding and cutting. Trafimet's new logo is the signature of that future, and our customers are the basis of that future. Long-term experience and industry know-how help us to meet their needs. Partnerships with research centers and universities makes Trafimet research and development team to be able to translate their problems into most technologically and ergonomically advanced solutions. An example of this new plasma torch of Trafimet was designed in cooperation with the latest technology information of Bologna University. Founded as a small artisan's workshop, Trafimet has since grown to over 22,000 square meters of manufacturing floor space in Italy. We want to make our customers' welding and cutting experience better, and we want all Trafimet to be visible also in the new brand and in the new products of Trafimet.
A very warm welcome to everybody, and thank you for joining us today. We hope you had a great start into 2022. Today, I promise you, it's getting even better. Today, we are showing you everything what is new about Trafimet, and that's quite something. So please fasten your seatbelt, relax, and enjoy the show. My name is Sven Hegemann. I'm the commercial director at Kempi for the business unit Guns & Torches. Next to me, there's my fantastic colleague, Etu. Etu, please say some words about you.
Hello, everybody. I'm really glad to be here. And first, I have to say that R&D have made a really good job with new products. With the engineering and industrial designing, our products are on a next level for sure. I'm excited to be able to tell you more about it soon.
Thank you, Etu, for the quick introduction. I believe our audience is most excited about what new products are we going to show today. So maybe you can give us a quick overview what our audience can expect.
Yes, for sure. For the MIG welding, we have a new Ergo Plus. And we have a film extraction torch Ergo Fresh. For the plasma range you see over there, we have a new PlusCut series. I will definitely tell more about those soon.
Thank you. Great. I would say let's start with the MIG equipment and our new Ergo Plus model.
For sure, we can start with it.
Ergo Plus by Trafimet is very well known in the markets now for decades. It's a really well-known product already. But if I look at this product here now, I need to say it looks like a totally new product. So what is new about the Ergo Plus A2?
Almost everything is new on a new Ergo Plus. There is not much to similar compared to old Ergo Plus. I would start about ergonomics, because for ergonomics we have put a huge effort.
Well, that sounds good to me, because the ergonomics are for the welder the key part to make his work comfortable and stressless. So Ito, what did we do about ergonomics to provide our welders a really stressless job?
On our new handle, we have a triangle shaped which follows a natural position of hand. And also trigger angle and shape supports different holding positions on your finger. Tapered handle reduces stress when hose package pulls the torch away. And the new slim design enables slimmer handle and excellent ergonomics. And also center of mass is optimized between neck and cable package. And last but not least, I have to mention dual texture on a handle. We have a rubber on the top of the handle and also another rubber part on the downside of the handle. With those rubbers, you can really make sure that the grip is precise.
Let's take a little bit closer look at this handle design, because I know our R&D put huge efforts into this and make a lot of thoughts, try to get inspiration, try to find innovative approaches to design a handle. I know we took really huge efforts into it, and we try to follow the natural position of the hand as much as possible. So if I have here the handle in my hand, it really looks and feels firm and really good control of the handle. So Ito, you may explain us and the audience a little bit better. What did we do with the handle design to follow the position of the hand? What was our inspiration and what is innovation here in this handle, and what is the benefit for our customers?
Yes. For the first, I can tell about the natural human position of the hand. The human hand position is more or less a triangular shape when you are closing the hand. And we've been following that triangular shape on a gun handle. And when you are taking it, you exactly know the position and it's locked on your hand. And as the example, the axe. When you are using axe with the standard shaped axe handle, you really know the direction of the tool. And also with our handle, you don't have to look where you are heading the gun. You know it exactly because of the handle shape. You always know where you are heading with the gun and the gun neck. And one part of our design leaders has been also those firefighter hoses and the hose handles. When you are pulling something with you, it's good to have a bigger shape here and a precise grip over there, so it doesn't slip away from your handle on any kind of use. So those has been our design leaders on a new handle.
This is, sounds really, really interesting for me. And now imagine to hold an axe into my hand where I really need a firm grip, and everybody of you who ever hold an axe in your hand, you know how important it is to have a firm grip. And that we follow this idea into our torch, I think makes also for the welder a lot of sense, as he needs a firm grip if he's doing the job. So I think this is a very interesting approach and very good job here from our R&D. If I look at this torch here now, I see we have here a kind of accessory. We call it pistol grip. So Ito, can you tell us something about this pistol grip? Why do we have it for our torches?
Yes, it's my honor to tell about it. It's a detachable pistol grip which can be removed by pressing one button in 1 second. You can remove it or put it back, also that easy. And with the pistol grip, you can reach a different position for your arm and give a less stress for your muscles. I can give you an example.
Please.
For example, if I'm welding this weld over there, now you can see the position of my elbow and my shoulder. It's completely stress-free, and I can also see what I'm doing. And for the example, let's have a look at without pistol grip, doing the same job. You see my elbow and my shoulder. What is the difference?
Yeah, I can see it.
Yeah, there's a lot less muscles working on my body.
And with the pistol grip.
With the pistol grip, definitely. And about pistol grip, it's measured together with company called Myontech on a EMG measurement. And that Myontech is an Olympic level company who's been cooperating with the Olympic teams to reach most stressless solutions for their needs. And on our cooperation, we did a study and found that when you are welding with pistol grip, you can reduce your muscle stress depending on welding position from 24 to 65%. So less stress for your body, less sick leaves for your employees, and
But I think this is very good that you mentioned it. I mean, for our customers, it's always important that we have proof for what we are saying. And I'm very happy that we found this company, Myontech. They're working with sport athletes together, and they know what they're talking about when it comes to muscle stress. So with this pistol grip, we have a clear proof. It reduces the muscle stress on the welders when they're working and when they're doing the job. As Eto showed, and I think this is a really big advantage, you can take off and on this pistol grip with a click. You don't need any tools. Put it in your pocket, take it away. Wherever you need it, you can take it on, take it off. This is very important because there are many positions where the pistol grip is not so good. So take it off, put it in your pocket, weld without the pistol grip. If you need it, put it on. So I think this tool is very good and a very advantage and benefit for our welders. Itu, big question now. Our audience is probably asking the same question. Do our customers need to buy this pistol grip additionally, or is it as a standard with our torch?
Yeah, I'm really happy to say that for you, that pistol grip is included in every standard package of Ergo Plus.
Can our customers take the same pistol grip on all Ergo Plus models, or is there a different pistol grip?
It's suitable with every Ergo Plus models and also for some other Trafimet gun models. Later about that.
Great. Now, we've talked about the handle a lot. A big part of the handle is a trigger. So I know that we have a new trigger in our Ergo Plus torch, completely mm-hmm. different than our trigger in the old Ergo Plus torch. Please tell us about what is new on the trigger on the new Ergo Plus.
On the trigger side, we have updated mechanism inside the trigger. On a previous model, there was a mechanical contact, which is not that well protected and not that precise contact. On a new model, we have a micro switch trigger, which has a perfect and precise contact. Power source knows always when the contact is coming and when it's not coming. And also on the micro switch trigger, we have a IP67 protection against the dust and humidity.
So I imagine that a sealed trigger is very important for our customers because where they work, on their workplace, in the workshop, there's a lot of dust and dirt. So our triggers are protected about dust and dirt. So we have a longer lifetime of the trigger and providing every time a precise control of the trigger. But you mentioned also IP67. IP67 for our customer means water protection. Water protection is good, and also IP67 seals and protects the trigger about corrosion. Corrosion, if I think about corrosion, I think, for example, about our customers in Asia. In Asia, we very often find a high humidity, right? So our triggers are protected against humidity, against corrosion. So you need to change your trigger less often, saving costs, less spare parts. I think we have a clear benefit here. Really good to have this micro switch trigger in our new Ergo Plus.
And one of the important things on our triggers is that we still have kept a good feeling on it. After a few clickings, I'm pretty sure and I know when I got the contact. It's always on the same position and I have a precise feeling when it clicks and when it doesn't click.
Great. So we're talking now about ergonomics, about our new trigger. But if I look at the torch in your hands now, I also see we have a new bending protection here. Bending protection is also good for protection, but also good for the ergonomics. Can you tell us a little bit more about the bending protection which you have here?
Yes, this bending protection is our new double ball joint. And the double ball joint allows good ergonomics and a good balance between hose package. And also it has a new innovative connection for the protection hose. Protection hose is really well mounted inside a ball joint, and it's really durable against the rough use. But more about ergonomics of the double ball joint. With double ball joint, we can rotate and bend the gun however it's needed and do a welding on a difficult positions without stress on a cable package. And all the weight of cable package is compromised with the weight of the neck, so this whole chain is on a perfect balance.
Sounds very good to me too, but I look now at our gas cool torches and it looks for me very obviously here we have a different approach than to our water cool torches. The water cool torches come with a double ball joint as you presented it now. Our gas cool torches has a different type of bending protection. Can you tell us what we have here and why do we have here a different approach than with water cool torches?
Yes, on a gas cool range we have a different kind of solution because we are using coaxial cable instead of cable package. Coaxial cable is a smaller and more solid one. So using double ball joint is impossible on a coaxial cable models. So we have chosen a single ball joint with a plastic spring. On that solution, we have a flexible connection between handle and coaxial cable, but also the root of the cable is well protected. And when we have this spring support, we have also increased the length where the load comes. So it's the part of the balance of this gun as well. It gives a protection and keeps the gun on perfect balance.
Great. So now we have also talked about our bending protection. A very important part of the torch as well is the end, is the connection. I know that we have also made changes compared to the prior model, to the old Ergo Plus model. So what did we do in the connector or in the connection of the Ergo Plus torch?
Yes, indeed. The Euro connector, we have improved usability. And now we are using EPDM rubber hose material on our water hoses, which makes them more flexible and gives them a higher lifetime. Furthermore, we included now a bending protection for the water hose inside the Euro connector, as you see from the picture.
So the bending protection inside the Euro connector, why did we do it and why did we put it in? And for what is this bending protection inside the Euro connector? Why is it there?
That's a really good question. Of course, it's already protected by plastics, but as you can imagine that we are turning the water hose in a small place. And in that case, there is a huge risk that water hose gets kinked and it doesn't allow the water flow. So we have that kind of bending support inside a Euro connector to make water flow reliable. We don't have any kind of risk that water circle is not going on inside the gun because of that protection.
So we have this bending protection in our water-cooled torches in the Euro connector to protect our water cables. First of all, about breaking, about damage. So we have a longer lifetime about the water-cooled cables inside of the torch. And of course, we provide with this bending protection at any time a really reliable and smooth water flow and thus a very good cooling of the torch. So nice feature. We talked now almost about everything about the torch. the handle, bending protection, Euro connector.
Trigger.
One important part we forgot so far, and this is the neck. The neck design of the Ergo Plus. Are there any changes compared to our prior model? Did we do anything new here also on the necks?
Yes, definitely. They have done also new improvements for the neck. On a water-cooled model, they have done a structure completely again. And now we have reached better water cooling. And as a result of that better water cooling, we have a cooler contact tip. In our laboratory tests, we have found that contact tip heat is 30% less what we have on a previous Trafimet models. And with a better cooling on a contact tip, we can reach long lifetime of consumable contact tips. So it's a clear benefit for the customer. They are saving money and they don't have to change the contact tip that often.
So, I mean, a lot of our customers already know the old Ergo Plus and they know the good reliability of the old gun or the old torch. So now we have our own benchmark set and compared our old equipment against the new equipment, which is very transparent for our customers. And we can say that our new torch has a 30% better cooling, thus a longer lifetime of the consumers is guaranteed. So we're saving a lot of costs for our customers. And I think this is a good thing. So the well-known models of the Ergo Plus keep the same. We have the 15, the 24, the 25, the 26, the 36 for the gas cooled torches, and our 240, 400, 500, and 555 version for the water cooled torches. Itu, we talk now a lot, but I think our customers really need to get this torch into their own hands. We explained all the benefits, all the new features in the torches, all the great ideas which are behind these torches. What led our R&D to do so, what we did in the torches, for example, the handle design. I can only recommend to our audience outside, get the torch into your own hand. You will feel a difference. It is a complete new welding torch. You cannot compare it to our old model. And this torch, I need to say, it's a really great innovation of our R&D. So get it into your own hands, make your own mind and test it. So, but now I think we went through the Ergo Plus, and I'm very excited. What's next? Itu, let's talk about safety, fume extraction gun. You told us in the beginning that with the Ergo Fresh, we will have a fume extraction gun, a new one. Please tell us something about it.
Yes, we have. We have this Ergo Fresh fume extraction MIG gun. It's pretty much based on Ergo Plus MIG gun, but it's with the fume extraction. And with the fume extraction gun, welder and the people who are working on the same environment are on a safe.
So, meaning on the safe side, so they are not...
They don't have to breathe welding fumes, I mean.
Okay, so, it's clear. So, but how dangerous are welding fumes? Or are they dangerous at all?
Yes, I have to say that those welding fumes are dangerous. And according studies, a single welder operator can produce 40 grams of airborne fumes and particles per hour. And with Ergo Fresh, 94% of those welding fumes can be removed as soon as they are generated. So long before they are ending to the welder's breathing area. Also, those small particles and metal oxides and silicates and fluorides are not visible to the eyes. So have to keep on mind that even it looks safety, that you don't see those welding fumes, they could be dangerous.
Clear. So message is clear. Fume extinction torch is needed, especially in those cases where the welder is not used or cannot use a separate vacuum unit or exhausting unit. So we need a fume extinction gun. But now we're having all these additional features for the fume extinction on the torch. Mm. What about ergonomic? What about the weight?
Yeah, we have the same ergonomic approach than on Ergo Plus. For example, this small and slim handle with the same kind of triangular shape, which I already mentioned with the Ergo Plus. And even there is a fume channels inside the handle, it's small. And hose packets must be larger, of course, because there is a fume hose inside the hose packets. But because of this one big joint ball, it's still flexible and it keeps your working ergonomic. And there is only one big ball joint because it have to be also there won't be any leakage. For example, if we are putting multiple ball joints here, there would be a lot of leakage. So on our Ergo Plus, there is a really minimum leakage on this gun. Okay. But in ergonomic wise, we have reached also this good level on ergonomics. So working on difficult positions is possible with the minimal bending force from the hose packets.
So overall, we can say that we copied the same ergonomic approach from the Ergo Plus and put everything into this fume extinction gun, into this Ergo Fresh, right?
Yes, as much as possible, I have to say. It's really good level. Take a try.
Really feels good. And if I look at the handle, not much compromises on the ergonomy and the design is still there. You can identify it from the Ergo Plus. It is a small handle. And look now here, these house package. Is it leather?
Yes, it is real leather.
Why do we use it? I normally have leather on the jacket or I don't know where in my car on the seats, I don't know, but why do we put leather here on the fume extinction torch?
Yeah, actually I have to say that it looks really nice, but it's more because of ISO requirements and gliding over sharp corners. Those ISO standards requires a hot wire test, so it must be durable enough against hot wire, and with the fully leather we can glide it over sharp corners pretty smoothly. I can demonstrate it here. If you pull it here, there is no any gap on this side, and
this really it's sharp. But if you say it's really sharp,
it's really yeah, and it's really durable against the sharp corners.
So, okay, I think we can really conclude that this DC torch is really very close to a normal welding gun, to our normal Ergo Plus gun. And this is very important for our welders outside. If a welder is using a fume extinction gun, he doesn't want to take any compromises onto ergonomic, and he doesn't want to have any huge weight on the torch. He wants to have a torch where he can really do his job, be safe, have all these features for the fume extinction gun, for the fume extinction, but doesn't want to have any compromise ergonomic. And I think very well done here. No compromises in ergonomic, but providing full safety. So, but Itu, very honestly, if I go now to customer side or on site to workshops and manufacturing sites, I need to say, I do not see a lot of these torches around there. How do you see the future of these torches, about this equipment? What do you think about it?
In my opinion, these are definitely future products. Safety things has become more important in every country, in every company, and they appreciate a welder's safety. For example, it's even difficult to find the welders, but if you can give them a safe working atmosphere, it's easier to get the employees for that kind of jobs. But also in the future, after safety is megatrend, as I mentioned, but there is some regulations in some countries. For example, in France, companies are able to get rebates of taxes if their employees are using fume extraction gun. And I'm pretty sure that this kind of regulations will become more widely in the future.
So overall, the market is driven by, of course, the safety of the welder, which is the most important thing. But we also see regulation and subsidies coming up for those for this equipment, that it comes more and more in place. Itu, by the way, and look now at this torch. What is this blue thing here on top? What is it? I know it from my little bit from my fume extraction unit from at home. But what was it? Why do we have it here on this torch?
Yeah, exactly. It's called bypass lid, and it has a similar meaning that what you have on your vacuum cleaner at home.
Vacuum cleaner, right?
But in a welding point of view, it's more about a shield gas. For example, if I'm welding somewhere nearby the inner corner, and if I'm coming to inner corner, there is a risk that I will vacuum also shield gas away. But with the bypass lid, when I'm coming to position where is that risk, I can easily move the bypass lid and reduce the amount of vacuum. And with that adjustment, I can be sure that there is no welding defects because of too strong vacuum. So it must be possible to move easily by a thumb during the welding task.
So I can see also it's very well positioned here. It is directly below my thumb. It is directly where I can use it during welding very easily. If I go into corners, do not want to harm my shielding gas. I really easily can adjust the flow here on this handle.
Exactly.
Itu, if we have now here the same design approach than the Ergo Plus, what about the pistol grip you mentioned earlier for the Ergo Plus? Can we put it here on the Ergo Fresh as well?
Yes, for sure. We can use the same pistol grip. We can take it away from Ergo Plus and just please go ahead and put it to Ergo Fresh.
Easy, one click. Off, on, works here as well. Same.
Yes,
ergonomic
advantages
than for the Ergo Plus. Great. Mm. Now, if I have here the pistol grip and now have here the trigger, what about the trigger? Do we have the same trigger here in the Ergo Fresh than also in the Ergo Plus's micro switch trigger? Do we have it here also?
Yes, it's the same. But before that topic, I want to remind you also about the pistol grip that it's included in every standard package.
Ah, here as well.
Yes, in Ergo Fresh as well. Every welder is able to get the benefits of pistol grip. But now answer for your question. About the trigger, it has a same design shape. The angle for the human hand has the same approach than we have on Ergo Plus, but also it has the same micro switch trigger, which is IP67 protected. And you can imagine on reality when you are doing your job with the fume extraction gun, the hot fumes goes inside the neck, inside the handle, and there is a lot of dust and particles inside the handle, which could cause some electronic problems with the trigger components and the conductivity of those components. But we are using this IP-sealed micro switch component, so we don't have any risk on that point of view.
So the micro switch trigger, even more important in the fume extraction gun to protect it from the dust and the fume coming through the handle. So very good here.
Yes, precisely.
Itu, one important part of the fume extraction torch is, of course, the front, the gas nozzle and the fume nozzle. Please tell us something about how did we design it, what is the idea behind, and do we have something unique here or something very special?
Yes, I'm feeling proud to tell that this fume nozzle and gas nozzle combination, we have a patent pending for it. It's unique. None of other has a similar kind of structure acceptable by same standards than us. In our solution, we can change gas nozzle and fume nozzle separately. Please have a look at this video.
So do I understand right from the video that I can separately change the gas nozzle and keep the fume nozzle on the torch, right? So
yes, precisely.
Okay, what is the benefit for our customers? Let us think about. Probably this fume nozzle here has a much more longer lifetime than the gas nozzle, right? Mm. So if I only need to change the gas nozzle and keep the fume nozzle, I save costs, right? Because I do not need to save the whole set here. Mm. I only can, or only need to say, only need to change the gas nozzle, keep it here, and if needed, okay, I change the fume nozzle, but longer lifetime. So I only.
Exactly. And you can imagine the price difference between combination and between gas nozzle and the fume nozzle separately.
Exactly.
And as I said, it's really unique according this 21.004 or CARSAT standard, because they require it together, but this is accepted by it.
So, okay, so this approach or pendant design, which we have here for this exhausting and also this separate approach of the fume, the gas nozzle is covered and is aligned with the new ISO 21.904, and we also align with the CARSAT standard from French market. Do I get it right?
Exactly, exactly.
Okay, then a big question is, what kind of vacuum unit do I need for this torch?
That's a good question. For ErkoFresh, a low-power vacuum unit is enough. Needed vacuum air amount is approximately 95 cubic meter per hour.
Okay, so I can use this torch with almost most of the or all of the units which are applicable in the market. So no special requirements beside this 95 cubic meters per hour. Nothing special needed, so I can use it almost with every machine in the market, right?
No special requirements.
Great. Itu, I have a question to you. You mentioned also now, or we mentioned now, the ISO standard. You mentioned the efficiency. We have 94%. I'm a little bit confused, I need to say. What is really behind these numbers? What does this efficiency mean? How do we measure it? I see a lot of high numbers. If I look at the fume extraction torches in the market, a lot of high numbers without knowing what does it really mean? What is behind it? How efficient the torches are really? Can we put any number here? How is this measured? Please help me a little bit to get a little bit more clear picture. Mm-hmm. How do we do it? How do we put transparency to our customers? And how do we prove our efficiency, that we really have a proving behind our numbers and don't tell anything?
Yes, I can tell it for you. We are talking about the minimum flow with capture speed and maximum flow with capture speed. This capture speed is calculated air speed at the distance of 20 millimeter from the end of the gas nozzle. The test requires multiple measurements, and we can take the average of those multiple measurements. Those are measured in a laboratory. And minimum capture speed means 0.35 meters per second, and maximum capture speed means 0.55 meters per second, according that standard, which we have to use for fume extraction guns.
Standard, you mean the ISO standard?
Yes,
so we
exactly.
measure everything under this ISO 21.904. So we are completely aligned with the standard, and all our measurements are done under this requirements from the standard, right?
Exactly, exactly. And before we go ahead, I want to tell you that with ErkoFresh, minimum capture speed, we can reach 90% efficiency, and with the maximum capture speed, we can reach 94% efficiency.
Well, so our customers can clearly compare this efficiency due to the ISO standard, so we do not hide anything. We are very transparent, open, and everybody understands what we did here. And no bullshit numbers. Sorry to say something like this, but this is really proven facts. So, Itu, last but not least, how do I connect this torch to this vacuum unit? I mean, this is an important question to our customers. We explained now that you can mostly take the machines which are available in the market, no really special requirements, but how do I connect this torch to the machine? I think this is a very important question.
That's really important question, exactly. Here we have a standard Euro connector, which is a similar what we have on ErkoPlus. And after Euro connector, we have this connector for the vacuum hose. Works easily, and this connection rotates freely 360 degrees around. So there's no kind of limits where the vacuum hose should come. And also, if you are moving your wire feeder or moving your gun, however, this is really flexible solution. And this connector size on a standard model is a diameter 50 millimeters. But we have adapters available for 45 millimeters and 60 millimeters. So also as we mentioned, according vacuum power, we can say it according this, most of the standard vacuum units from the markets can be used easily with no special actions.
Good. This is very good to know to our customers. Now, coming to the end of the presentation of the Ergo Fresh model, of course, our customers are curious and want to know what models are we going to have available in the future?
Yes, that's a good question, and I would like to go through with you. For the water-cooled range, we will have a 300 amperage model and 500 amperage model. And for the gas-cooled range, we have a 200 amperage model and 350 amperage model. And as a cable length, we have a 3-meter, 4-meter and 5-meter models. So all in all, we have 12 different models available.
This is very good. So to sum up these new Ergo Fresh, we can say that we have a torch here which provides full safety to our welders with no compromises in ergonomic. So, Itu, what's next?
Yeah, next we have a topic on the left side of us. There is a plus cut.
After showing now the MIG equipment of Trafimet, the Ergo Plus and the Ergo Fresh, I believe our audience is very excited about what did we do in plasma. Trafimet is known the market for plasma torches for years. Now with the plasma torch, the PlusCut, we have a completely new product. There's no prior model, there's no product where it's based on. It's a completely new developed torch. So I would say it's our new flagship. It's our new flagship when it comes to plasma, and we are very proud of this torch. And you say, Itu, can you give us a first small overview about these torches?
Yes, of course. These PlusCut torches are developed to the most demanding industrial and professional use. These are available on an amperage range 45, 65, 85, and 105. And also we have this coaxial cable opinion and this cable set opinion. Later more on details. And for both solutions we have a 6-meter model and 12-meter model. Plenty of models for different kind of use. And all these PlusCut models has a pneumatic ignition. And those are for the machines without high-frequency start.
Thank you, Itu, for this quick overview. But let's go really into details about the benefits of this torch and talk really about those. If we take the most obvious here, the design. So if I look here to my right, to the Ergo Plus, and then have a look at the PlusCut torch, it looks similar. So can we say that we took the same design idea and brought also the PlusCut torch?
Yes, we definitely can say that there is the same design leaders on a PlusCut. The handle material is a two-component, and it's an anti-slip rubber material. With this anti-slip surface, you can have a firm grip whatever position you are using the plus-cut torch.
So we also followed here the design to follow with the handle, the natural position of the hand, to lock this torch, as we know from the prior picture with the X, we see it here again. So also here, the torch is locked to my hand with this triangle shape. So really precise cutting control and no bad surprises, right?
Exactly, exactly. And as you can see here, the triangular shape, even without watching, you know that what you are doing, what you are heading, where you are heading with the torch. The human hand position has been the design leader also on this.
Very good. And so, yeah.
To be honest, I have to say that this handle design is patented. So we can say with such a proud feelings that none of competitors has the same kind of handle.
This is, I think, very good. So, and gives us our customers and really a good feeling about this torch. So, having the torch in my hand and talking about cutting, if we talk about cutting, the trigger has an important role if it comes to cutting. So can you tell us a little bit more about what trigger solution do we have here in the plus-cut torch?
Yes, I can tell you. On a trigger, first you can see we have this safety trigger. Safety trigger is required by safety standards of plasma cutting torch. It works like pulling a safety lip away, and then you can press the trigger.
So without putting it away, I cannot start the cutting, right?
Yes, exactly. It doesn't move without pulling it away. And on the inside of the handle, there is a same kind of micro switch trigger, what is used also on Ergo Plus and Ergo Fresh. So it's well sealed with the IP67 protection, and all the contact points are really precise. And on the designing point of view, it's made really well, because even after few clickings, I can recognize where is the actual contact point of the trigger. Mm-hmm. You know, when I'm starting the cutting, I don't have to wait that when it's starting and when it doesn't start. I know it after few tries, where is the contact point.
Very interesting. I had this torch on my handle, and I saw here some, I don't know how to call them. I call them knobs.
Okay.
We have here two knobs on this trigger.
Let's call them knobs.
So what are these? Why did we put them here? What are the purpose of these small knobs?
Can I show you an example?
Please.
Okay. If you're having this torch on your hand and on a cutting position, for example, if you are reaching a little bit far away and pulling the trigger.
At
the end of the trigger, exactly. Without those knobs, you could quite easily slip your finger away from the trigger, especially with the cutting glow or welding glow what you are using. But because we have these knobs, we have really precise control for the trigger, and even on difficult positions, I can make sure that I have a contact with the trigger.
Yeah,
please try that reaching.
So sometimes it's really the small things which makes it really the difference.
Yes, that's
so
right.
So really, if I only put it here, no slippery, I have really control of the torch. This is very good. So hearing what you all saying, again, we can say that we put enormous efforts in the ergonomic in the torch, so we can provide a really comfortable job, comfortable work for our workers and cutters doing the job, right?
And that kind of small details makes the combination
on a good
product.
So very well thought product. So talking about well thought, in the beginning you said we have two different cable sets, coax cell cable and cable set. Let's go to this. Why do we have two cables? For what?
Yeah. For the beginning, I have to say that we have to provide solution for every kind of customer. This coaxial cable is better known from markets already. most of the plasma torches have this coaxial cable, and it has a lot of users who appreciate and wants to have it. It's the best solution on a situation on a harsh environment where the for example forklifts are driving around, and when you got the scratches against the corner, it's really durable and well protected.
So forklift, I can drive around my cable, I take the coaxial cable, yes. Because I feel a harsh environment, I take the really robust one.
Yes, exactly. But on the other hand, it's not the most flexible solution mm-hmm. on the markets. But for that kind of need, we have our cable set opinion. On a cable set, the biggest benefits are exactly on the flexibility. Have a look at this.
Yeah, this is really flexible.
Yeah, it's from
the coaxial cable.
It's from the other world comparing the coaxial cable.
Also with the leather for the first 50, 60, 70, that's 70 right. centimeters, we have a leather protection to make it even more flexible and nice, protected. So yeah, I can feel it's much more flexible.
And in durable point of view, I can say that both opinions are tested with a robot arm with a multiple
multiple servers.
Yes, okay. Yes, and they are both are durable for the bending, for the rough use, but different type of use.
So I take this torch probably if I need more flexibility. Let's say I need to do more guided cutting, right?
Yeah.
So then I take this flexible solution, and a little spoiler alarm already here for mechanized or automated cutting. High flexibility is needed. So be excited what's coming next year. But let's go back to this torch. I also can see that we have here a ball joint, which supports the whole flexibility of the torch. So this, I believe, makes the torch even much more flexible, which we don't have on the coaxial cable solution, where we have a spring solution.
Yeah, that's right.
Here is a steel protection there.
Steel spring solution. I can give you an example nearby our workpiece. For example, if I have a cutting position like that, I can reach really difficult cutting positions, and I can rotate it once and without no big affection over there because of the ball joint and the hose package system. And it's also slides smoothly over the corners. Mm-hmm. So no problems also in that point of view.
So with the ball joint in the leather, it's also very easy for our customers to identify which torch do I have or which torch do I want. So the coaxial cable with the spring is easy to identify, and here the cable set with the ball joint and the leather in the first centimeters or meter of the torch. So really easy to identify which torch is what. I think this is a very good idea. But now we talked a lot about these ergonomic features and this great ideas and the patent and handle. Let's talk about performance. Let's talk about results.
Yes.
So, and if we talk about performance and if we talk about results of the cutting, we need to talk about consumables. Consumables are very important and crucial to reach a perfect cutting. So what did we do regarding consumables and also the lifetime of consumables with the PlusCut torch?
Yeah, we have done a lot, I have to say. A lot of studies and research are made for the consumables to provide most precise manufactured consumable parts and with the highest tolerances. And this torch head is also patented, as well as the handle. And with Trafimet airflow technology, we can provide high quality cutting results and with a high cooling efficiency and with a long lifetime consumables.
So these are a lot of words and sounds everything great, but let's go a little bit more into detail. What means patented? Why is it patented the torch neck and what is different? Trafimet airflow, what is behind all that? Let's go into detail.
As you see from the section cut photo, everything this happens inside of this copper part. There in the middle there is blue arrows for cooling the electrode. It's a separate from each other from other air channels. And then there is a red arrows, which is a primary airflow. It makes a few circles and comes out from the hole at the end of cutting nozzle. And then there is a yellow arrows, which is a secondary airflow, which comes also on its own air channel and comes out from the end of the cutting nozzle.
So do I get it right if I say that we separate the cooling channel for the electrode in one channel and then we have two channels for the airflow for the cutting? Is this right?
Yes, exactly. And all of those are separate from each other.
So three separate channels and separate cooling of the electrode.
Yeah. The cooling air of the electrode has a separate part from primary plasma airflow. We did this to not affect the primary cutting airflow by the cooling airflow. In the most other solutions, cooling air and primary cutting air are using same channel. If using same channel, the airflow can be affected by the heat of the striking area. With our new design, we keep the plasma arc much more stable on cutting tip channel. Thus, we can provide much more longer lifetime of the consumables.
This sounds very interesting, into especially the airflow. Can we have a closer look at the airflow? And you mentioned already earlier that we put a lot of studies and research into this airflow and into this patented neck. Can we maybe mention one institute with whom we work together to really create this great result? Is there somebody behind also supporting us and working together with us?
Yes, definitely there is somebody behind us. We have developed this in a collaboration with Bologna University in Italian. And they have a special plasma team in Bologna University because plasma is like born in Bologna University, and they have a highest technology inside the university, and we have used also a lot of their experience when reaching these best possible cutting results. And a little bit more about more details on that point of view. I already mentioned that there is a separate channels for different airflows. But on this photo, which is provided by Bologna University, you can see the laminarity and turbulence on the airflow. On this photo, laminar airflow is marked by blue and turbulence is marked by red. So from the photo, you can see that on a plasma arc, we don't have a turbulence at all. All those turbulence are coming away before and with the best possible measurements on our air channels, the airflow is fully laminar over there. And I'm pretty sure that next you are asking why it must be laminar. I can tell you before you ask it.
You can read my mind, so perfect, please.
Yeah, well, for the basics of plasma cutting, when I'm cutting, I'm melting a metal with plasma arc, and then I have the airflow to blow this melted metal away. And of course, you can imagine if you blow melted metal away with the basic pneumatic air, the surface is really rough. But when we have a plasma torch with the circle on airflow and with the secondary direct airflow, we will have the best possible cutting results. And the airflow is so smooth and laminar, so then we can reach good cutting quality.
So can we say as a conclusion that the plasma torch head is very well balanced, to avoid and designed to avoid any turbulences on the arc.
Exactly.
Right, on the plasma arc. And the optimized airflow is also optimizing the cooling of the consumables. Is this right? Do I get it right?
Exactly. So which increases the lifetime.
This increased lifetime of consumables. And talking about increasing lifetime of consumables, saving costs, these claims are very often here in the market, so longer lifetime, mm-hmm. cost savings. Do we have any proof? Did we do any tests? Did we do anything to really have data to prove our claims here, to prove our facts? Did we do something that we really can say, yes, this approach, this neck, these consumables are better?
Yes, we have made a comparison between our competitor, and here you can see the results of that comparison. This comparison is made by 20 seconds manual cutting after each others. 20 seconds always, 20 seconds with the same setup for both brands. And for the results, you can see that with plus cut we have done 288 cuttings with one consumable set on an amperage level 105. And with the competitor torch, we have done a little bit more than 200 cuttings with the one consumable set. And on a level 85 amperage with plus cut, we have done 404 cuttings with the one consumable set. And there you can see also competitor results, which not on the same level at all. So we can say it clearly that our consumable lifetime is way longer than what competitors have.
Okay, two things to be fair. We need also to mention, of course, that the machine needs to support the torch. So we can give the performance of a torch, but the machine needs to follow. And you said it, we did it with a manual cutting. If you would probably do it on a mechanized cutting, the numbers would be even higher. So, but this is our result, what we get, and we can very openly show what we did and how we do it here to our customers. So, Itu, we talk now a lot about the consumables. And consumables is really important for our customers with a longer lifetime to saving costs and have less consumables. This is one important fact on the one hand. On the other hand, if you're talking about plasma cutting, we need speed. We need speed to increase our productivity. Our customer needs speed really also to save the costs from a production point of view, productivity point of view. And I know that it is always very difficult to develop a torch on the one hand having the long lifetime of the consumers, but on the other hand then really reaching the speed our customers need. This is a really, 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 really fine balance. So what did we do about the speed? So what did we do with the speed, and how is our torch performing with the speed?
Yes, this balance between speed and consumable lifetime is also recognized on our R&D work. When we are talking about clean cut, we have a standard speed 0.25 meters per minute. And if we are talking about clean cut, we have to reach good quality cutting results. And with plus cut, we have done it for 10 millimeter plate for the 45 amperage, 12 millimeter plate with the 65 amperage, 30 millimeter plate with 85 amperage, 35 millimeter plate with 105 amperage. We have reached clean cut results. And the severance cut is another topic. It's a kind of okay cutting quality, but nothing like a clean cut. With severance cut, we have reached the 50 millimeter material on the highest point.
So can we maybe a little bit explain what does clean cut a little bit more? Are there any data or norms which we need to reach to say that, hey, we got a clean cut?
Yes, that's right. We are talking about clean cut if RA number is smaller than 3, then it's high quality clean cut. And always when we are measuring these cutting qualities, we have to use 0.25 meters per minute. And here you can see from the photo the results what we have reached. There is a RA 1.2, RA 1.9. So we are on pretty high level.
On the maximum thickness, 35 millimeters, right?
Yes, that's right, exactly.
So very impressive results. Yeah. And I think we've also a video which we can show here to also let customers see about the cutting results.
Yes.
Okay, coming to the end now, in the back we have, you know, really some other photos, pictures that we want to show to our audience also with 40 millimeters here with a nice cut. it was all impressive what we showed here. And in the end, our customers need to test the torch and make their own mind. I think that's the best way how we can convince them and show them about the new quality about this Pleska torch. I think it was very impressive. And now coming to the end, I really need to say that we really found the balance between a torch which provides a long lifetime of the consumables and also providing the needed cutting speed our customers need for doing a good job. So I think well done here. And as I said at the beginning, this is our new flagship. We are very proud of it. We did it in a very good cooperation with the University of Bologna. And we can really say, made in Italy torch, made in Italy consumables. Same for here, made in Italy. So I think the new products are really something which we are really proud and cannot wait that you guys test them outside there.
Keep it on my plus cut.
Yeah. Itu, I think this was very impressive. We showed our new product lines from the MIG equipment and the plus cut. Mm-hmm. This was, I think, really good stuff for our audience. And now coming to the end, by the way, Itu, and now I have these one more think moment. I feel a little bit like one more think. Did you notice that we have a new logo?
Yeah. Yes, I have noticed, and I'm pretty sure that our audience has noticed it as well. But well, please tell me more about it.
Well, probably they noticed it, don't you? But we can tell you guys, the logo is not the only thing what changed. We really rethought our complete rebrand. We went in every corner and said, okay, how do we need to improve? What do we need to do different? How can we give Trafimet a fresh design, a better design? So, and we come out really with a completely new brand identity, brand promise to you guys. The products we showed you today were only the first step in our new development, and this was a huge step. But we will also change our communication, our services, how we approach to you guys. We have really something new, and we will be something new to you, and we will communicate different to you, and we have much more higher promises to you. The torches, the new logo is not the main thing. We have also the new homepage coming up. If you go onto our homepage tomorrow, you will see a completely new homepage. On this new homepage, you will find everything we showed you today, the new products. You will find our new product catalog. You will find the new brochures. So a lot of stuff to download. We keep you updated there frequently. Our homepage is really easy to understand. We have a modern swipe approach. You can easily go from the bottom to the top and find everything you needed on a very simple way. Very, very, very easy to use with all information about your Trafimet world you need. And you will find there also the Express Cut. The Express Cut is the updated product from the well-known ErgoCut in the past. We also developed this product. We come up with a new product design. We come up with a new product design for the ExpertTick, which was in the past the ErgoTick. So also this product was developed. You find all information on the homepage. We need to come to an end. I enjoyed it, but the best things need to come to an end. So for today, I need to say again, thank you to all of you. And hopefully see you guys all also in the future face to face, talk to you, how we can work together with these new products, what we can do. I'm really happy to meet you all there. But for today, again, thank you joining us. Thank you listening to us. Thank you for spending the time with us. And that's it from my side. I can only say thank you, bye-bye, and ciao.
Yeah, hope to see you soon and stay safe. Thank you, goodbye.
Ciao.